It's the one and only beast day. You gotta stay woke. Stay woke. Stay woke. Questioning brings about understanding. And understanding brings about knowledge. It's the one and only beast day. Test B if you're dyslexic. Got a heart made of gold and a smile big as Texas. It's the one and only beast day. You gotta stay woke. Stay woke, stay woke. Questioning brings about understanding. And understanding brings about knowledge. It's the one and only piece stuff. Test B if you're dyslexic. Got a heart made of gold and a smile big as Texas.
He look like a baby predator.
No. Y'all ready to start?
Look, man, we have started. Yeah. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2, in the house tonight, and we're gonna make it do what it do. Let me get on the beat. It's the one and only beat stuck, and we compete, complete your week, and we stay woke. What we got to say ain't no joke.
No
to my
joke.
Left
is Mike.
What you know?
I'm alright.
To my right, Bridget.
Bridget.
Get it.
Get it.
Got her glasses on and she on her phone.
That's the end of that.
Always one motherfucker fuck up the freestyle.
What's up, Bridget? You got your finest Black Friday on a Monday outfit on.
No, I don't have on no Black Friday.
She scarfed up.
That's not a Black Friday scarf.
No.
They're like one of them secret weapons you use when you're trying to get a TV. And you just choking that guy with that.
It's actually a secret weapon you wear when it's cold outside.
When it's cold outside.
When
so
it's
it
cold
protects
outside,
your neck.
Yeah.
Who's going to protect
well,
your neck?
I'm glad to have you back
I'm
on.
I'm bone chic tonight.
Yeah, it's an urban chic.
Yeezy has inspired my outfit for this evening.
Well, I don't see no holes in it, so
it's
not
holes.
Authentic.
It's
Yeezy.
Tanked. It's a little... It's, you know,
nah,
it's mangy
man,
a little bit.
I got some drawers. They got holes in them.
Yeah.
And I think they Yeezy.
They're not.
And they
just
like,
trifling.
They like $782.
Yeah, I got the Yeezy socks, man.
Yo. Everybody got Yeezy socks. You're supposed to throw them away when they get Yeezy.
I remember my granddad used to have the undershirts, and it had the hole under the arm where he used to... Like the deodorant he used, 8 through the 3.
What kind of deodorant? Your granddad must be used. Tussie.
Yeah, that Old Spice. You know, that Old Spice.
I'd be wondering how them hoes get in my like wife beaters.
He had the Old Spice with the Brute. That's what old men wear.
Yeah.
I ain't old enough.
You almost old enough.
Not to wear a Brute.
You almost old enough.
I'm just young enough to not enjoy Kim music.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm scared to get old and enjoy Kim.
Yeah.
Kim has good music.
No, he does not.
Yes, he does.
He got old ass gout music.
he has good music for when you just want to chill.
Kim got
sip a little wine.
Kim music. You like I keep
light
Kim
some candles
on my iPod just in case, like if I got to take my mama somewhere and I don't want the car to be silent. You can play Kim music if I want to get my aunt a ride somewhere.
Kim is, y'all not going to do Kim like that.
Kim make music when
he
you
does
have
a wonderful job.
For niggas with
what
ashy
he does.
Knuckles. You got to have like,
no, they be pretty moisturized. Nah. If you think about the people who listen to Kim, they would be very moisturized. They smell good. It's older men.
Mm-hmm.
Let me show you. This is how Kim.
They
wear
like
well
three
maintained.
Different. Yeah, three different colognes and shit.
Yeah, they keep some Nivea lotion in there.
But then they be
the
having
car.
Like them powder hands.
Like, that's you young guys have these ashy knuckles and stuff.
Not,
y'all don't take good care of yourselves.
I'm talking about like I met what's his name? Uncle Charlie Wilson. And I shook his hand, right? Let me see your hand.
No. I don't want to participate in this demonstration.
Look, let me see your hand. Look, and it just slid off. Like as I tried.
They were tender.
Yeah.
His hands were tender.
Now you know he got all kind of oils from what he put in his hair.
Good oils.
And then
yeah,
he
that
put good
saying.
Oils
you know,
on his hand. That's good.
He got put he
he
put that oil.
Nice
it's residue from what he put in his hair.
Mm-hmm.
Well, when you listen
moisturizer is moisturizer, no matter where it come from.
Well, when you listen to Kim music, man, they like it almost like you gotta have your Affordable Care Act card with you.
Yeah, Kim music sound like the people who play the music at your church form the band, and they playing that secular music.
So what y'all trying to say? Cause I like him.
Oh, that mean you old?
I'm not old.
Okay.
I'm a young tender 30.
Okay. With a couple years on it.
No, I'll be 31 next month.
Really?
If you play Kim music for when you about to make love, you got to have on one of them furry negligees.
That's not for that.
Can you dab on them with Kim?
You can dab to anything.
Really?
I don't even know what dab. I don't know what it is.
You know, I'm still trying
to. I thought it was like, let me put the head in.
It looked like
that's not what dab is.
No, I'm saying.
Yeah, what is it?
Like you do that, like you smell.
What does it mean though?
It means like you dabbing. I don't know.
You don't know. Let me do the Urban Dictionary. Yeah, that always helps me.
Because, you know, Cam Newton been dabbing.
Yeah.
And like.
And they talking about him.
Yeah, white folks been going.
Yeah, man. They say he a thug now because he dab.
I mean, he just.
He's like the opposite of a thug.
If you don't. I mean, look. The tried and true method is. If you don't want to see him dab and dance and all of that shit, keep him out the end zone.
Okay.
Them niggas 10-0 dab. Right now. What is dab? You went to the UD on us.
Yeah, it says to touch one's foot to the ground while bicycling.
Okay, that is not.
No, I don't think that's the one we talking about.
That is Caucasian.
That's what it says. And this is in the Urban Dictionary.
Yeah, that's
considered to be a lost style point among trail riders, mountain bikers, bike polo players, among others.
I thought it was like if a girl wear a lot of makeup and she starts sweating, she
dab herself.
Dab on it.
Is that what that is?
Or another. Like I said, when guys use it, I thought it meant when let me put the head in, like let me just dab it.
Hilarious.
Okay, here we go. Dab. This is what it is.
Okay.
To administer a drug in powder form orally by getting some on the index finger and rubbing it all over the gums.
No,
that's what a dab is.
I don't think that's what.
Yeah, I don't think that's what.
Oh, okay.
I think we might have to go to YouTube.
To stay off the nose candy for a while, but then every now and then you dab.
Okay.
So it's.
I think it come from a song, Bridget. Don't it come?
Yeah, it comes.
Well, I don't know. I don't know. I'm doing the best I can over here.
You're doing a good job, but. You sinking fast.
See, I go where the young folks go, the non-Kim listeners go. She Google like a Kim, somebody who listen to Kim, don't she?
Your Google search got me.
I have slightly, okay, this one says dab, drunk ass bitch.
That's what I thought it meant. Oh, I thought it meant down ass bitch.
That's the next one. That's definition number 16 is down ass bitch.
Really? So
I still don't know what the dab
is.
There's also dumb ass bitch.
Yeah. What about Dave and Buster's?
That could be dab.
That's it right
Dave
there.
And Buster's. Yeah, I like dabbing. That one.
What this about is, yeah.
He dabbing on them.
I'm still looking.
What about
it's rough out here trying to find a definition for these terms.
It is, man. It's like it changed so fast. I mean, it was just kind
of I'm disconnected.
Yeah, we only fucking minutes away from listening to Kim.
Oh, here we go. A dab. Okay, a short rip of marijuana taken from a small electric dab piece. Dabbing, the act of taking a dab.
Now it looked like this guy on this video.
Yeah, he dabbed.
More than marijuana. They're like synthetic marijuana.
So he's doing the line of coke that you rub on your gums.
Yeah.
Nah, he rubbed in his fleek cap.
That's dab right there?
Yeah, that's the dance. Mm. So, Bridget, man, you know, I talk a lot of shit about natural hair journey.
Mm-hmm.
And I talk about, you know, how natural hair look. And it's not how it's supposed to look on when you say natural, because it's levels to natural.
You know, no, natural hair. Is your hair's natural state.
Yeah, but some of it look like fireworks coming out top of your head.
Well, that's their natural state on their hair.
Or it's supernatural because it has seances on it. However, I have gone hard on the women. And so I'm here tonight to say I apologize because right under my nose, Mike, I ain't stay woke. Niggas are going through their own natural hair journey.
For real.
And they call it the fleek look. And we have not covered it on the show. I wanted to wait.
I've never heard of that.
It's the look that you see all the guys having now.
The basketball players, with where the they have the little...
The football players.
Sideshow Bob haircuts.
It looked bad. It looked like... It's not the Sideshow Bob. It looked like the... The
Bart Simpson.
No, it looked like the dollar store push broom mop. You know, with the different colors on it. And then it'd be like, you'd be looking for it to be $1, but it'd be $1.69. And then that's without tax. And the shit got the little aluminum foil handle on it, and the shit bending when you're trying to use it.
Right.
That's how niggas' hair look right now. And I'm trying to see, like, is are men going through the same... Are men going through... Is their reasoning for having this look the same as women?
I don't even know the reason that women do it.
Well, you know, women want to say, well, it's in my natural state, and they don't want to use chemicals, even though they'll throw some color in that motherfucker.
I don't think that it's chemicals. A matter of not wanting to use chemicals. I think that people are just finding a sense of pride in their natural hair texture.
Yeah, I think...
For a long time, it was shameful. You wanted to straighten your hair. People would talk about it and stuff, and I think now it's a movement to show pride in yourself.
Right.
So why are dudes doing it then?
I think that they are also showing pride in themselves.
No. See, I think it's different for women, because regardless of how you put it, right, when you when a woman straightened her hair, it was, if you delve back into it, it was some attempt to mimic European hairstyles. And I think dudes that do it, they just want to be cooler. Whatever.
I will say, like, we are now witnessing a generation of children that grew up in the 90s. And the 90s is when their parents had these hairstyles. They had these, you know, they look crazy back in the day.
Yeah.
Everybody looked crazy in the 90s.
Not me. My shit was so
you
tall.
Did too.
My
everybody looked so crazy
tall.
In the 90s.
My flat top was... So
yeah,
tall,
and it was
so.
A flat top.
Mm-hmm.
It was looking just
but it
crazy
sloped.
As everybody
It wasn't really
else.
Flat. See, it sloped.
But my point is that I think that they have seen photos of their parents, and their parents are like, hell yeah, he looked like I looked when I was his age. Mm-hmm. And they're cool with it.
Right. But it looked like, I think a lot of those kids that have their hair like that, they don't have parents.
They do have parents.
They don't have nobody to tell them to comb
their
hair.
They do not have parents.
They look thrown away.
They don't. That's a look.
They test tube babies.
They look thrown away.
They look created, like, in this Geechee laboratory.
Especially when they dye bright colors. I really hate bright color hair on anybody.
I mean, like, I saw a guy, I was watching a football game Saturday, and this guy, he took his helmet off, and I was like, damn, this nigga look like Reptile off of... motherfucking Mortal Kombat. And then he had the push broom mop from the dollar store look on his head, and it looked like he had actually swept up some stuff, because he had like an old Sweet and Low rapper stuck in time.
See, I was warning everybody about this years ago. I used to tell y'all about the dudes who were suspect to me, who had dreadlocks. And then dip the ends. The ends would be a different color.
Different colors, yeah. So that's real suspect.
That shit is the natural evolution. Guys, that shit just creeping up to here, man.
But I think those guys are the fathers.
Mm-hmm.
These kids. Because that was my era.
Yeah.
Yeah, that
you
is.
You know what I'm saying? And so I remember them dudes was impregnating them chicks in high school.
Yeah, see, if you're a grown man and you got a colorist.
A colorist.
I know a 30-year-old and a 17-year-old,
nice.
And this nigga has the fleek look. That's what they call it.
Yeah. Their fathers wasn't around, man.
So
their fathers are the ones taking them to get them awful haircuts.
Yeah, that doesn't suck, man. But speaking of, like, fathers and all of that.
Why did not have nothing to do with fathers?
Yeah.
Have absolutely nothing to do with fathers. Speaking of fathers, did you see
the young man get his ass whooped at the Donald Trump rally? Was he a father?
I don't know, man.
I don't know if he's a father or
do
not.
You know, I know this nigga. I know that nigga.
You know, I had
you know, and you know him too, Mike.
I probably do, because you know, I had the girl from Black Lives Matter on the podcast. When you see this, you can listen to her interview too.
So look, check this out. last year. Wait, was that last year or earlier this year?
When?
When you did the...
That was a year ago. Almost a year ago, exactly.
At the summit?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, so you laid in the street.
Right.
Man, niggas was just on the side. I'll never forget that dope-ass song they were singing.
Don't kill him. Don't shoot him. Don't hurt him.
Man down.
On the ground.
Okay, so when nobody get out in... This was so...
Have you seen that video?
Yeah.
You got it.
Yeah. So nobody got in the street, right? Mm-hmm. So after that video came out, Mike put the video out. It was two guys
that were
in a Walmart parking lot.
They were embarrassed, kind of.
They were embarrassed, and I mean, I ain't saying they was trying to one up you.
They said it before on the internet that okay, we're gonna get arrested this week.
Right. So one of those two dudes mm-hmm. was the guy at the Donald Trump rally.
Right.
And it seems like he's been on a crusade ever since then to not only one up you, but like. Dust your ass.
But see, first of all, that was never my intention to even lay in the street. But the second thing is, right, I always wonder, like, to go to a Donald Trump rally, like, what's your ultimate goal? What's your end game, right? Like, do you think, like, let's say, for instance, Donald Trump somehow loses his mind and say, you know what, we're going to get this nigga the mic and let him say whatever he want to say. Do you think all the people in that rally are going to say, well, you know, I never heard that before,
yeah.
and now you changed my mind?
Yeah.
And then, all right, so let me ask you this. And because BJ made this point last night we was talking. He said that Donald Trump had the floor.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really kind of disrespectful to start yelling because basically that was heckling.
Right.
Doesn't mean it really was when you think
about it. Yeah, that's heckling. But
so at what point does it cross the line? I mean, he had to know he was going in there and get his ass whooped.
Yeah, but see, this is the thing, right?
Can
you say that's racist, right? Because let me ask you this. If you went to see, let's say you went to see Young Thug, and you interrupted his concert, what you think going to happen to you?
I'm probably going
to get your ass beat, right?
Yeah.
The motherfucker's going to... If you go to the club tonight
and
fuck with the DJ,
right?
They going to grab you up and whip your ass.
What's the goal, man?
I don't understand it either because it doesn't endear anybody. Even the people who believe what they believe, it doesn't endear them to the Black Lives Matter movement.
And then how did he get in there? They had to know this nigga was going to set this off.
Because
it wasn't like he had on, like, I support Trump 2016 outfit on.
Make America great again.
This nigga had, didn't he have a Black Lives Matter?
Because
I remember at a previous... establishment that I used to work at, they brought this guy in and we interviewed him, and he had on a bulletproof vest over like a muscle shirt.
Mm-hmm.
It looked really weird. It looked like I think it looked like ET or some shit. Mm-hmm. It was kind of funny, but I mean, he had that on, and I'm like, how does brother get in? It's like they set him up for fit.
Right.
Then it was some other Black folks in there.
Mm-hmm.
And
they didn't make a move to help him.
They didn't make a move. Now, I did see a dude in a suit.
Yeah.
I don't know. It looked like he was joining in, kicking his ass. Did you see that, Rich?
Yeah, it looked like... okay, so I have a slightly different perspective than y'all do. Even if he was being very disrespectful, and you can look around and see like people holding beers and stuff at this rally and all that kind of stuff, and I mean, supporters of Trump had no reason to beat him up.
Right.
They're not security,
right.
Nothing like that. Like if you went to a concert or if you went to a Kim concert. And Kim was like, you know what, somebody out there being very disrespectful, y'all whoop his ass.
Man, them pointed toe shoe wearing niggas.
People not really finna whoop nobody. You're not gonna, if anything, they'll help carry him, get him up out of there. But ain't nobody finna just, I'm talking about the dude was on the ground. They were kicking him, punching him,
and
like,
yelling, and still yelling, holding all on to their. Did you hear that part?
No.
Yeah.
They were still holding their beer in one arm, was whooping his ass
but,
with the other
arm. Let's put it. First of all, I don't agree. I don't think that it was right to whip him. I think that it was expected. right? Because right. now what you the yeah. analogy that
and
you're
and
you
think about the people who are there, they yeah. them type of people.
The analogy that you're using is different because you have to put it in the perspective of if you were at a Kim rally and like a dude was passing out flyers for the KKK. Mm-hmm. That's how they view Black yeah. Lives Matter, right? He might get his ass whipped. Right?
Yeah.
Because that's how they the white people at a Donald Trump rally views Black Lives Matter, like terrorists, people who are trying to upset the natural state of things.
So, right, because they're crazy.
So I don't know if it was, I'm not saying it was right, but it was expected. Like, there's, I wouldn't
yeah,
expect
I
any
was
other.
Yeah, I'm surprised that he went in there by himself like that. That was ill-advised. Now, maybe you could do that at a Jeb Bush rally mm-hmm. or something like that, where he's going to be a little bit calmer and try to keep the peace. But Donald Trump has not one damn ounce of sense.
Right. I told you, I keep telling so, people, I've been saying for months, what?
He is Sarah Palin.
He is going to say nigga.
Yeah, he's going to slip
before
up.
Before the Iowa call. Not slip up. He going That shit is calculated what he's doing. You saw what he tweeted yesterday, right?
Yeah, yeah.
About the statistics.
Black right. on black crime and stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Which was wrong.
It was all
And false. It was wrong and said that. What did it say? Like 87% of white people killed by black people.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. When it's 82% of it's, white on white.
Yes,
84%.
84% of white.
Yeah, it's basically
white
the same
people
as black
by other white people, which is the equivalent of black on black crime, right. because crime is usually done against people who you associate with
right.
or know
right.
very
right.
well.
It's almost right. equal.
Right.
Right. It's like 84 to 89%.
But
right.
see, all right. So this is why I feel like Donald Trump has a serious shot to win, because you can just throw something out there that's a total lie, but just cause you that dude right now, niggas gonna follow you and not question, and then like folks ain't gonna question and find out that it's 84% white on white crime. Mm-hmm. They just gonna look at what Donald Trump said. And that's the gospel.
Yeah, because that was not something that, like a graphic that Donald Trump created. He
That was a freaking meme.
Yeah,
he probably
was something
took
that,
it
yeah,
from
somebody
else. From someone
else
who was
tweeted
racist.
It to him. Yeah.
Right. And they tweeted it to him and he reposted it.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, so.
He is crazy. All I know is if he really does win the general election, I got to go.
He will not, y'all.
Y'all not going to see me right here no
where
more.
Where you going to go, Brittany?
Somebody Island. I'm not going to be here no more. I can't deal with him
hey man,
as president.
He is not going to win. Don't worry about that. Because first of all.
But we, man,
right,
we in that generation.
See,
where
he's winning now, but he's getting like 34% of the vote. When all those other people start running out of money, those votes. Everybody.
Money,
who, hmm? No, what
money?
I'm saying is the people who are running against him, when they start running out of money.
Yeah.
Their voters aren't going to, because everybody who's on Donald Trump's side is on Donald Trump's side right now. You know what I'm saying? So when Huckabee runs out of money, his supporters ain't going to Donald Trump.
You don't know
when,
that.
When
yeah,
Jeb
man,
Bush people.
But you don't know that.
Like these folks might, they hate Obama.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like they hate this nigga.
Mm-hmm. And he's not even running again.
He
cannot run
again.
He can never be president
right.
of the United States again.
But see,
but
just
the momentum. That, you know, what his presence will unite these motherfuckers.
Yeah, but see,
they've been sitting in an incubator.
Just like, yeah. just like I said to Bridget, man, don't leave because Donald Trump is gonna make it as bad for black people as Obama made it good for black people.
So let me ask you this: who gonna beat him? Cause like I support Bernie Sanders right
I
now.
I do as well.
But
he is
really
the equivalent of Trump, though, if you really want to think about it. Like, he is the left-wing
yeah.
version
yeah.
of Trump.
Yeah. But he makes sense, though. Like, he ain't.
But
he
is not outrageous.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a complete antithesis of that.
Yeah.
But he's in the sense that he says whatever he wants to say. But what Bernie Sanders is saying is kind of corrupt. Like, you can't just fact-check Bernie Sanders and say, oh, all of that is wrong.
But
yeah.
But what I'm saying is, do you really think that like
he's
this utopian society that Bernie Sanders is
no,
creating.
That's Bernie Sanders ain't gonna win either.
He
he's got
saying.
As much of a chance as Donald Trump, right?
So who
but,
gonna win?
But
Hillary
the people
not gonna win
who
right
who
now.
Decides
Hillary gonna steal that money.
See, here's what y'all forget, right? All of those that lead that they talk about Donald Trump having, those are people who already identify as Republicans, who are going to vote for the Republican candidate anyway. And it's like 34%. The elections are won with the people in the middle, the moderates, the people who don't identify with the party. And they ain't fucking crazy.
Elections are won by corporations who pay in elections.
Yeah, well, I mean, elections are decided in a room smaller than this one, really. Yeah. You know, I don't believe in that.
So that's why I think he could possibly win.
Yeah, because he going to go up in there.
He can buy it. He can buy into that room.
Right.
But see, the people who decide that shit, it ain't money, man. I'm keep telling people, money,
it's actually gay shit.
Nah, it's fucking power.
Why do you think the Pope was here?
Niggas
took turns jerking out the Pope and whoever did it the best.
Listen, Catholic people, the views of Be
That's
Stuck.
They won't, they ain't gonna tell you.
Right, these are only the views of Be Stuck.
Why the Pope gonna come?
They do not reflect the other two cast members currently seated.
Yeah.
You scared, say you scared.
I'm not scared, but.
But what's crazy is, if they're beating up protesters, right? I mean, think about when folks was popping off. Shout out to Obama for saying pop it off.
Yeah.
But when folks
Obama just don't give a fuck.
Yeah,
he like Janice from Accounting on what's our show with John Oliver that we like this week with John Oliver.
Oh yeah,
you know Janice from Accounting just don't give a fuck. That's how Obama is now.
So folks was interrupting Obama, and nobody stood up and smacked the shit out these niggas.
Right. Nobody jumped on anybody.
Right.
And he didn't say, "Hey, get them up out of here." He didn't say it either.
So. I mean, we're looking at an era. We are looking at the end of an era and the beginning of a new one where if I disagree with you, I can come up and heckle you. And if you disagree with me and you heckling me, I can command my crowd to beat the shit out your ass.
What it sounds like?
Is that what we're doing?
Hitler.
That is some Hitler shit.
That ain't.
That's very much some Hitler shit,
but it's some shit before, like in between Hitler shit and Obama shit. That it is also. It is
Stalin
just like
shit. That what it is. Some Stalin.
Some white mass crowd influence shit, like mob mentality, like pitchforks and torture shit.
But here's the crazy thing about it is that okay. We're moving deeper and deeper into this politically correct society where you really don't know who you're gonna piss off next. It's a compartment of niggas just on the internet waiting to get pissed off about something.
Yeah.
And then it may be one or two people and they can command that social media to turn on your ass,
but
just because they disagree with you.
It's that fake outrage, man.
It's the fake outrage, but what's the end game on that?
There is no end game for fake outrage.
First of all, like everybody believes that just because they have a voice, their voice is valid. Like if you say, like I can understand if somebody doesn't like something I agree with or something I said. What I can't agree with is I should be quiet and not say it because you don't like it, right? Mm-hmm. Like, you don't like those haircuts, therefore, motherfuckers shouldn't get them. Nah, you're just saying you don't like them, what it means and everything. You're not saying outlaw those haircuts. Let's go to barbershops and convince barbers not to do those haircuts.
But then that's what they do, Mike. Mm-hmm. They'll turn it into a word and
a
say,
cause.
You're haircut shaming me.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's real ignorant.
Haircut
shaming.
And then
victim. Your haircut
they,
blaming.
And then they. Yeah.
Your barber
they,
blaming.
Then they clench so hard to it. You know, I mean, it's funny, man. Like, I'm a big fan of South Park.
Mm-hmm.
And this season of South Park has really been exposing
PC culture.
The PC culture.
Right.
And it was funny where they have this PC principal, and
I love PC principal.
Everything he goes up against, like he's just been commanding his way.
That is the greatest character invention of 2015. PC principal.
But now he encountered this for you too, Bridget, because I know you don't watch.
Yeah, I don't watch it at all.
It's hilarious.
I'm lost.
He went up against a handicapped guy, and the handicapped guy was basically doing the same thing that he was doing, And they basically just kind of came to a head. Oh, actually, it's like a two-parter. Hmm. So we don't know what's going to happen. But it's almost like that's what it'll take to, I guess, turn the tide on this thing. Because I know comedians that will make a joke about a special needs kid, and the special needs community is cracking up laughing at it, at themselves, and just being excited that they're getting that kind of recognition. Well, but the community at large is outraged.
Not even the community at large. I'm going to tell you.
It's like two or three people.
It's those, what they call social justice warriors who want to fight. Like, they want to fight for black people for shit that black people don't care about.
Yeah, I hate
you
that.
You know,
yeah.
just like, I don't know if you read about the incident at Yale, where they want to rename the School of Business and all of the stuff that has Woodrow Wilson's name on it, because Woodrow Wilson was an unabashed racist. First of all, it's not like any new information came out that we are now finding out that Woodrow Wilson was racist. And
or any other president.
Oh, what do you think? A motherfucker who lived in the 1920s, who had all the power in the world.
I'd say the 80s and before. Anything right. before the yeah, 1990s. Like, if you were president before the 1990s,
yeah, and we're black folks are guilty. Black folks are guilty of it too. Like whenever they find a recording of a white person saying the word nigger, and I'm my position on that is, oh, I always assume that when white folks by themselves they use the word nigger indiscriminately. Like that don't surprise me.
Right,
oh, it's weird to hear them say it, but like I'm not surprised, the outrage, because I always think that they say it, and I'm not upset that. If they are amongst themselves, they say that shit. Like, cause, like, what's the alternative? Like, we should institute a speech task force to make sure that they don't say it when they're by themselves. People have the right to say what they say by themselves.
But you know what's funny though, Mike, is that, I mean, this not all, mm-hmm. but some white people mm-hmm. will listen to hip hop music mm-hmm. and get to the N word part, and they will mute themselves. Mm-hmm. And I laugh hysterically at that.
Right.
I think it's very funny. But I'm excited that they're yeah. taking that.
They know what it is. They do that shit around you, son.
Right.
They right. don't do that shit all
in
the time.
In the car.
By themselves.
Nigga.
It makes my teeth white. Shouts yeah. out to Paul Mooney.
Yeah.
But, you know, that it made me think about how folks are like, you know, they just kind of say whatever and just kind of pop out at the mouth and, you know, act like there's no repercussion for it.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the biggest symbol of that was Ronda Rousey.
Right.
Ronda Rousey was all over the news, talking about she'll beat up Floyd Mayweather.
Mm-hmm.
Matter of fact, me and my folks got into a heated argument.
I know how you're telling me about this.
Ronda Rousey could beat Floyd Mayweather. What do you think about that? Do you think? I mean, all right.
Well, we know now.
Yeah, we know now.
Right. It's not.
But she taught all that shit, and that girl, what's her name? Holly Holm.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, she beat the shit out of her.
Hey, she had Ronda shook before she even knocked out, like in the first round. But see, this is the thing, right?
Look how she did her, Mike. She didn't touch gloves with her.
Mm, yes.
With the arrogance. And you kind of see that if everything is relative. You kind of see that with the people that support Trump.
Right.
That beat up on this poor young guy. I mean, he ain't poor, but you know what I'm saying.
Right.
Where's our Holly Holm is what I'm asking.
We don't have one, man. We're not going to have one, man, because they see they're easy to get to them, those people. And I was having a conversation yesterday about Farrakhan. And the Million Man March. And
he would be Holly Holm.
No, he wouldn't.
Let me
tell you why. See, if Farrakhan could be Holly Holmes, Farrakhan wouldn't be 70-something years old. Like, nobody that had...
No, they wouldn't let him
Yeah,
long
you know
hair.
What I'm saying?
They would have got how him you up know,
right. Because, yeah. see, let me tell you
yeah,
something, right?
True.
You think about Mike Brown and Trayvon and Tamir Rice and John Crawford and all of those people, right? Farrakhan legitimately... could put together like a 17-man force and go have retribution against all of that shit if he wanted to. He has that kind of power over some over a group of black people. Like, he have motherfuckers in 103 degree heat selling bean pies in the summertime, right?
Giving out newspaper.
Right? So he could do that shit, but he ain't really did anything substantial as far as, like, that's why they let him live. They know, man.
Yeah.
What you think, Bridget?
That's a very good point. Anybody who has that kind of power to really join, like to really bring people together and stuff like that, mm-hmm. they die. So
right, yeah, and
they die before they hit.
That's one thing. That's the smart thing, or the sellout thing that Farrakhan always did. He ain't never tried to bring people together, right? You know, he lets you know that he think white people are devils, and you know, he don't even barely fuck with Christians.
He's a Trump too.
Yeah. You know, Farrakhan knows what he's doing, and he stayed in his lane.
Or like the opposite of, or the equivalent of Trump.
Right.
Who else?
Well, I said Bernie Sanders is the equivalent of Trump. In this election, he is, where he says things that are outrageous, and that appeals to people like me who are seeking truth. And then you have Trump, where he's expressing some other people's truth. You know, and that's really what it comes down to. Everybody has their own truth, and you got different people picking sides. Well, Farrakhan has that type of following as well, where he's speaking some people's truth.
Right.
And it's stuff that people would be ashamed to speak out on, and he's unapologetic about saying it, just like Trump is. So.
But here's the thing, right? So those people like Trump, like Farrakhan, see, those people are of a previous generation when, like, the real truth doesn't have to be shouted out by one person now. Because, like, really, man, especially, like, y'all younger than me, your generation has access to being conscious that, like, a lot of the previous generations didn't have. Like, this generation ain't as lost as we think.
No.
You know, they portray us as being lost because, like, it's just like the rap game, right? So we all of us know 1,000 motherfuckers that's trying to be rappers, right? 80% of those dudes are saying, like, legitimately interesting, good stuff. But the 10%, 20% that's saying some stupid shit, like Young Thug, like Chief Keef or somebody like that, those are the ones they pick and put up on a pedestal and give record deals to. And so people think, oh, this generation is lost, or, oh, the hip-hop game is lost. Nah, man, you just listen to the shit that's on the radio.
Right. Well, I mean, I just think overall, man, people have lost their way. And, you know,
talk to the mic,
son. Oh, I'm sorry, I am off mic. I was saying, I think people have lost their way, and you know, there is no blueprint to follow. It's everybody's leading off emotion and, you know, just vitriol, because no one will tell the truth. I mean, you're giving a truth, but not the truth. And we see that reflected in society over and over and over again, is that we will go out of our way to not be truthful and create truth around a lie. And case in point, we all know what George Zimmerman did was fucked up.
Right.
I'm using him because he was amongst the first to really set this domino shit off. Mm. And if they had just given us George Zimmerman or Darren Wilson or any of these police officers, you know, these initial fire starters, just giving them to us, let us take him out, because he does not deserve to be here, then we would not have, you know, Ferguson beget Missouri. That Missouri shit had them white folks shook. You know what I'm saying? And if it just get cut off in the impetus, in that, like right there in its infancy, then we can start, like, I guess, moving along as a society. But we just keep going.
But you see, you have a faulty premise that they are concerned about what we think or how we...
us, yeah. And I saying it. Mm-hmm. Because you see us adopting what the larger culture thinks, mm-hmm. and further moving away from who we are, and we off our square, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, it's painful, and it's like this, it's like we're just circling this drain, and it just keep going down, where it's real simple to just plug that shit up and stop it. And
yeah, man. I think it's like if you have kids, right? So it's some shit you might tell your kids, and it might turn out to be wrong. But you got to tell you, because, you know, like my mom used to say, if I question her, because I said so. Like, they not giving us Darren Wilson or Darren or George Zimmerman because they said so. Because they got to be in charge. And they're not going to let any speck of us getting one up on them exist, right? So they got to stomp out all of that shit. They can't give us Zimmerman. That'll just embolden us.
When y'all say give us, what y'all talking about? I done got lost. When y'all say give us somebody.
Prosecute him or you know.
Give us a win.
Let a hit squad go and murk their ass.
I feel like the whole George Zimmerman was to a certain population of people what O.J. Simpson was to us.
Yeah.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
So we've had...
But they got OJ.
They got OJ.
Well, no, OJ got himself. He got himself up out of there. Because once you get a second chance at life, you go sit down somewhere and be quiet and you chill.
This is how they got OJ. They took this nigga memorabilia and started selling that shit at a time where his checks was bouncing.
Whose fault is that?
Hey, they did what he thought was necessary.
Nah, they did OJ. Because, see, even before that, right, OJ... Yeah, OJ won the case, but no, like, they effectively prosecuted OJ. Because, like, nobody was fucking with OJ after that shit.
Yeah.
But he didn't go to prison for that.
No. And old boy.
Just like Zimmerman is not going to live a normal life. He was prosecuted.
Yeah, by us.
Same as O.J. Simpson.
But the thing is, right?
Nobody is going to take him seriously. Nobody is really going to want to be affiliated with him unless they are crazy, just like O.J. Simpson. But at the same time, he didn't get prosecuted in the court of law.
Right. But I still feel like George Zimmerman still has his small group of supporters. And
I just think it's easy to hone in on certain aspects because we see... one side of things, but if you look at it, there are some cases where black people get off and you be like, they should have took their ass to jail.
Yeah, I agree with you.
So it's the same thing for every race of people. Like, it's some people that should have took their ass to jail, but they didn't, but they still not gonna live a normal life because people recognize them. Now, I'm not one for send somebody to kill them. Like, I'm on the side of right. So that's no matter what race you are, I'm on what's right. And I don't think that it's right to kill someone because that's not your place to kill someone. Just, it's not an eye for eye.
Let me ask you this.
So you didn't clap when they got Osama bin Laden?
No.
Well, let me ask you this, Bridget. What's right in a stolen country?
That's true.
But what, and what's
very
what,
valid.
And this is the other thing is,
and the nation is also built by criminals. England sent their criminals over here. So the fact that people expect descendants of criminals to be better than criminals,
and what's
is what's amazing.
And
to
you
me.
Have
like,
to ask
the fact
yourself
that people
this.
Are still surprised in 2015 of anything racist happening. That's what surprises me is that people are surprised.
And what happens when right is the opposite of what is just, right? Because I mean, if things were just, George Zimmerman should have lost his life like Trayvon lost his. If it was just, right?
Okay.
Who's to
say that would have been just for him to lose his life?
I mean, if it was just, then the whole situation would have been avoided. He would have let that little boy gone back about his business, and he would have left him.
Right, but we know, like, regardless of the intricacies of the case,
yeah,
if George Zimmerman wouldn't have bothered Trayvon, Trayvon would still be alive, right?
He would not be dead from that incident.
Right, he wouldn't be dead.
We don't know.
Yeah, we don't know. He could have been killed in a car wreck or something like that. You know what I'm saying?
He could have been.
But what my point is that George Zimmerman's actions caused the death of Trayvon.
Right.
No doubt about that.
Right. No doubt about that.
So, I mean, I don't know. Like, I don't know if some people believe in an eye for an eye, or like, if you rape somebody, but you know, should you have to suffer the same consequence? But it should be a consequence. Right,
there should be consequences, but I don't believe in handing over a person to a group of people so that they can just whoop his ass till he dies.
No,
that's what I'm not okay with. Like, that, there's nothing right about that, because he didn't directly do anything to you. So if we're talking about karma or what's right, it would only be right if Trayvon was able to whoop his ass and kill him.
Or his mom or his daddy.
Yeah, or someone someone directly related to it.
Or what is this? What? How about society at large?
But you have nothing to do, like, you didn't lose any sleep that night that Trayvon died. You didn't know anything about it until it got to mainstream media. So what right do you have to kill him?
Well, here's the thing, right? If, let's say, if somebody came and murdered somebody on this street right in front of us right now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Effectively, it is us who would, if they got the death penalty.
Let's not use that as an analogy.
Yeah, let's not use that as an analogy. But, I would like
effectively,
not to witness that.
Effectively, if they got the death sentence, we would all be participants in it by paying for the tax dollars. We elect the people. We elect the judges. So, you know, we participate in the deaths and what we call justice.
So do you
of
think
things that,
that
we have no...
If that's the case, if we're talking financials, then... Have George Zimmerman pay back tax dollars?
No, what I'm saying
is... To the taxpayer?
What I'm saying
is...
That's
not the same as death.
So what I'm saying is, if you were just picked for a jury for a death sentence, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you pronounced him guilty and he was sentenced to death. I mean, that really had no impetus. I mean, no impact on your life except that you were picked for the jury, right?
Right.
We were really kind of all on George Zimmerman's jury.
No, we weren't. That's what I'm saying, is we have no right to try to take anyone's life. That, like, to me, wanting to take someone's life makes you no better than him for taking someone else's life. He did nothing to you. He did something wrong. Yes, he did something wrong. George Zimmerman felt like Trayvon did something wrong. He whooped his ass. So he felt threatened. He felt like it was something wrong. I'm not taking George Zimmerman's side at all. But what I'm saying is, it's not right for someone who has nothing to do with the case, nothing to do with anything that happened, those events, nothing that happened,
nobody
who was related, for you to feel like you have a right to go and whoop anybody's ass.
But if you were on the jury and he was pronounced guilty and got the death penalty, it's still in the same. So you're saying just because you're not under the framework of the legal system, which I think that some of us might agree is wrong anyway.
Right, and I agree that that's wrong anyway.
If you weren't chosen to be on the jury, which... under a wrong legal system, then we were all effectively on that jury. Like,
well, let me ask you this: why do you feel so strongly that he should die?
Oh, I'm not saying that.
Well, B does.
I'm playing.
B does. So, what? Tell me why you would want to. Why do you feel so strongly that he should die?
Because he killed his man. I mean, he killed his little boy unjustly. He picked on him. He acted outside of a normal nature. And
okay.
It was basically animalistic.
So do you feel the same way about George Zimmerman that you do about anybody else who does the exact same thing that he does on a daily basis?
I don't know anybody. Like, that hadn't made it.
Well, we could find some. Let's Google. We could find other people who have been attacked, who have been murdered by people unjustly. There was a 9-year-old boy.
I will say that.
Who was killed in an alley.
Right.
Do you feel that you
right.
should that the police should hand those people who shot that kid
to a mob,
hand them over to you?
To me, yes, personally.
So that you can personally kill them.
Yes.
Why do you feel like you have the right to kill them? That's what I'm trying to see.
Because there has to be some sort of balance restored.
So then, who's gonna come kill you?
Oh, I'm not.
You see where I'm going with this?
No, I'm not even in fear.
That is unjust.
No. What I'm saying is, I'm acting in the balance.
No, that's not acting in the balance of the earth. You are acting unjustly because you have nothing to do with the crime, but you want to be the person who rectifies it. It has nothing to do with you. So then you go and kill that person. Somebody got to come kill you now. If we're going to be just. Because that the person who you killed, they were somebody's child.
So this is but my argument,
they,
right?
No, it's because they knocked off the natural balance and the natural order. It's all about Maslow's hierarchy of needs.
But that has Maslow's hierarchy of needs has absolutely nothing to do with what we are talking about.
Does. No, it does. The collective balance of the universe is off. Is off center.
But that I don't think you know what Maslow's hierarchy of needs are.
But see,
I'm adding it on there.
No, I don't think
it'll be Stuck's Maslow version.
Oh, be Stuck's version.
Maslow.
Be Stuck's hierarchy of needs.
This this Maslow Stuck.
I'm just saying, think about stuff before y'all be ready to kill somebody.
No, what I'm
I've thought it out.
Thought it out, and if you still want to kill them, then when somebody comes to kill you, we'll make sure we tell the people who killed you. We'll make sure that that mob knows, like, oh, no.
They not going to send no mob.
It's to equalize the balance.
They going to sneak and do me. They going to try to throw some high fructose corn syrup.
So, like, for somebody like Troy Davis, right, who was, like, most people say might have been probably killed unjustly.
Mm-hmm.
So should the person who pulled the switch be subject to the death penalty?
Because
all it is what we're saying is, like, so a group of people, what we call the legal system or a jury or something, said kill this dude.
Which we know
is not just. That's all they did. They said kill this dude. They said kill Troy Davis, right? It's just a group of people, right? Mm-hmm. So what you're saying is, like, the group of people that says it in one case is wrong, because it's just some random nigga saying George Zimmerman should die. But these people, because they were picked by a system that we know is wrong, mm-hmm. that's cool with that's cool to do because it's part of a pre-described system.
No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm not saying that anybody, like, I don't agree with any police officer who has killed unarmed people.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not okay with that either. But I also don't believe that it's just mass society. Like, if you have a group of vigilantes, like, once you encourage one group of vigilantes to go out and be like, okay, they did, that was justice, then you're going to have another group of vigilantes coming after somebody else and then somebody else. And that's why you have laws.
But what I'm saying is, okay, so
otherwise you have what's in the gang situation.
So ultimately, right, all you're saying is one side has to be the sanctioned vigilantes, right? That's all it is. Like, the courts and the jury and the person who pulls the switch and the prosecutors, that's just the sanctioned vigilantes. Because there isn't a death penalty, right? And they kill some people for crimes.
Well, speaking of...
Right?
Speaking of vigilantes,
mm-hmm.
the holidays is coming up.
Yeah, we can argue about this all day.
With anything else.
And we're basically celebrating vigilantes that came over here to this country,
mm-hmm.
and you know, basically set things on the course that we're
right.
discussing right now. But it's titled Thanksgiving.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I grew up in the church, so we used to have testimonials at church and talk about what we're thankful for.
Mm-hmm.
And so now Thanksgiving has become basically a meme for women that can't cook. And they'll call it cooking for bae. But before we get on that, what are y'all thankful for this Lenten season? That's what they be saying at church.
That's what they say. I don't know.
This is not Lenten season.
I know, man. It's just the way it
I
came
got confused
up.
For a second.
But this Thanksgiving season.
Why am I watch right or something?
What are y'all thankful for?
I am thankful, I don't know, man. I'm thankful for a lot of things, man. Thankful for my family. I'm thankful for the people that watch the Stay Woke show. Thankful that Jon Snow might not be dead. Thankful for all the gifts. Thankful for those naked pictures of what's her name? Got to get back to me on that. Those.
Delicious had some naked pics came out.
No, it was some more. It was some different ones though. But yeah,
That's so sad.
I'm thankful for the ability to hit the bottom of a woman's vagina.
Oh no.
What?
That's
not my struggle, Bridget. Think about all we done talked about.
Today. Yeah, man. I mean, like, look, you have to give thanks for all your blessings.
I hate you. Oh, man. I really can't stand y'all.
When you get hit the bottom of it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
What is a bottom?
The bottom is the back of the vagina. That it keeps you.
I ain't gonna never be able to share this show with nobody.
Yes, you can. Cause they if they ain't had the bottom of their vagina hit, then they need to hit.
When you
can
touch, are you thankful
when you can
for
touch the diaphragm.
I'm just thankful that's not my struggle. Like, I mean, I walk out of here and I could be massacred by the entire Birmingham Police Department.
That shit is a curse in some ways, man.
Right. I mean, we got police. Cause
your sperm
right
don't have
now
as far to swim when.
Well, I mean,
I'm thankful for completing my master's degree.
Okay, that's good.
And moving forward to my PhD degree.
An educated black woman. Mm.
And that's good too, Bridget, because if someone was hitting the bottom of your vagina.
Yeah, you might have been thrown off track.
You might be thrown off track. Are you thankful for that as well?
You know, you ain't never run into a friend that says, like, I never finished college. Why? He probably hit the bottom. Like, she met a dude, he threw her off track, she got pregnant.
I never heard anybody say that. Yeah. Usually it's financial aid.
Nah.
Just that I ran out of money.
Who's providing the aid?
Some girls say they fell in love.
Navy and now.
So what about Thanksgiving? Are you going to take pictures of your food?
No. Because it's going to look like everybody else's food.
Everybody else's food.
Especially in Alabama, we all eat the same thing.
Yeah.
There's no need for me to show people the exact same plate that they're looking at.
Now, I will say this. I want to see other cultures' food.
Now that, but do like other cultures celebrate Thanksgiving?
Like, what do Mexicans, what do they?
Why would they celebrate Thanksgiving?
Why wouldn't they?
That's an American holiday.
They do.
It is, but
they're like Mexicans in America.
They're Americans now.
Okay.
And they voting for Trump.
Highly doubt that. Highly doubt that.
It depends on what the La Raza say.
So if you're talking about people who are Americans, they're Americans. They're not Mexicans.
They're American Mexicans. Now, why? You ever think about that? They call us African American.
I call myself black.
I mean, I'm just saying. You know what I'm talking about. Even though black is a color. Even though black is a color and you fall into the under black law's dictionary when you in maritime law.
We're going into hotel territory now.
That was very hotel.
Come back.
But that's real deep though. That's real
No, come back, please.
But
Moorish science.
But they don't say I'm a Mexican American. Why is that?
Well, some people use Italian American. Some people use, but see, Africa is not a country. Like, it ain't no such thing as African American.
Because
you
could
be an Italian American or a German American or Irish American. I've heard those terms used a lot.
But not a continent American.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not a European American. You never heard anybody say I'm an Asian American. They say I'm a Japanese American, or you know.
I want to be a Venezuelan American.
Okay.
Just on some
just for the.
If Trump wins, a lot of syllables. I might be a Bahamian American because I'm going to leave for a little while and then I'm going to come back.
Trump wins. He's going to break out all the old.
Colored.
Colored. That was before nigga.
Right. Yeah, I'm going to get one of them.
Get out there, you moon crickets. You're going to be moon crickets. That was one of the
never
names.
Heard, yeah. I've never heard a moon cricket.
That's when you so dark. And you make sounds because we sing at night. So they called us a moon cricket.
So black people sing at night. We don't sing in the daytime.
Yeah, I'm going to get me one of them good wall building jobs.
Nobody was in the field at night.
Some people
then you would escape.
The moon crickets were.
Okay.
Some people were in the fields at night. I would guarantee you doing something.
They going to break them up.
But they weren't working.
So what about, is there any kind of etiquette that we need for Thanksgiving? You know, like I used to have, like my homeboy would come over from out of town and this nigga ate up all our chicken and my mama was mad as fuck, like even to this day. She don't fuck with that nigga like that.
Well, I was always ready. First of all, I hate the people who come early. Like if dinner's gonna start at 4 and you still trying to. Don't come at 3. And then I don't care how much you want to eat. Get one plate. Like, you can't have two plates because you want... If you one of those people who don't like your food to touch, you know there's some people like
oh,
that.
Oh, okay. I thought you meant, like, I can't have two helpings.
No. You got to have one plate at a time. You got to fit all your shit on one plate and then go back for seconds.
What about the people that always bring the same thing?
Well, that's my mama. She always bring a potato salad. But that's because people keep requesting potato salad.
No, I'm talking like, okay, we get so caught up in what meal you bring in. That, like, I be that nigga that bring the ice.
Yeah.
That's your thing.
But folks be talking about me, but then they be looking around for the cups, and you drinking high orange juice, high orange punch, and then ain't nobody got no ice. So I'm that ice nigga.
You gonna bring some Patty's Pies dishes?
Oh, man. That Patty Pie thing. I don't do sweet potato pie.
I love sweet potato pie, but that pie too light skin.
I don't do... It was not the right color.
Mm-mm.
And I don't believe in manufactured
you can't.
Baked goods.
First of all,
and them niggas I need to see an old
lady. Who won't see? Let me tell you.
Patty
I don't
didn't
care.
Really make the
I don't care how good you think the pie is. You have no credibility in judging it, in my opinion, if you are willing to eat
a cold
sweet potato pie.
I mean, and it.
Yeah.
Did you see the
you
way
you can't eat no damn cold sweet potato pie?
So we especially all saw the video bomb. Of the dude that that popularized it, right?
Yeah.
He pulled it out the package. I mean, like the plastic was still
and it wasn't cooked.
Melted on there a little bit, and it wasn't cooked.
No, do you cook them?
You are supposed to cook it.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm not eating a sweet potato pie. I don't.
Not out of no plastic wrapping. That's basically what they had boiled down to. Now let me ask you this though. This is the stay woke shit. Does Patty owe this nigga anything?
No.
Patty say the dude didn't help her sell no pies.
She didn't request him to make that commercial. So that's just like the people who riding around with Cheerios bought Chevys.
Mm. Yeah.
Cheerios don't owe you nothing.
No.
They didn't ask you to paint your car that way. So just like Patty didn't ask him to make that video. You on your own.
He missed out on a big ass payday.
He did, because he went about his business.
He hyped that shit up.
Right.
Till the shit went
but
viral.
He really was just making a silly video, but because we live
Me too, Mr.
Yeah.
Me too.
Yeah. Everybody gotta do it too. Like, oh, I'm gonna go get a patty pie too. I'm gonna get a patty that's what sold patty pies is. Bandwagon.
Yeah, we're sheep.
Followers and sheep, right. It wasn't him in his video. It was, did you see the video? I'm going to get a patty pie. Oh, you getting a patty pie? I'm getting a patty pie too. Well, everybody sold out of patty pies at this one, so let me go check another one. It was about, I want to fit in with everybody else who has, or I want to say that I was one of the ones who first experienced
right,
the patty
pie. Right,
because
I thought the video was funny.
It was just funny, but I didn't get a taste of that
I was
pie.
Like, damn, I'm going to go get me one of them damn
he
pies.
He didn't really describe the pie. He just said it was good and was singing. It was funny. It wasn't a, and then you can taste the nutmeg. You can taste the cinnamon. It was nothing. Like that, it was a pie. He could have been eating apple pie.
Yeah,
boo boo. It could have been anything he was eating, and people would have been.
You ever
he would have sang
boo-boo
a song.
Pie?
No, I've not had a boo boo pie. Never had a boo boo pie.
Nah, man, dude was and then he was like real flamboyant with it too.
Yeah,
right.
And I think that's what you know kind of tugged at the heartstrings of everybody, because you know them gay dudes, they get on there and everybody be laughing and stuff.
Yeah.
And then you sitting there eating it, and now you gay as that nigga.
So let me ask you this, right?
That's not how life works.
Let me ask you this, right? So what you just said, right? There's some people who are going to be outraged about that. Is that homophobic?
Mm-hmm.
I still say homophobic was a word that was created to justify bullshit.
Yeah, because see, if you point, like, if he was anything else, we would have laughed at it too.
Right.
Right. So just because you pointed out that he was gay, is that necessarily homophobic?
Well, we don't know for a fact that he was gay.
Hmm? No, but I'm saying he was flamboyant. Right. But does that mean you are, is that discriminatory against homophobic? Like, because I think.
I mean, how you gotta, the whole word discriminate.
Yeah.
I ain't denied this nigga housing opportunities.
Human beings laugh at things that are out of the ordinary. That don't mean right. we hate homosexuals. Like, for instance, right? I know this dude who was today telling me about his neighbor who was kind of cockeyed.
Right.
And, you know, I was laughing, and this other girl, she refused to laugh. She refused to even look at
me. That was 5 minutes ago.
That was me.
I wasn't even going to see
her. And I'm not going to let the devil use me. So you're right. I did not want to laugh at that.
But
I helped those
it was
eyes.
Funny. It was funny. It was funny. Now, the dude who
I
said.
I cock-eyed shamed that lady.
Yeah, he you don't have nothing against.
He eye shamed
like, people with strange eyes. It was just something funny, right?
Right.
Right? But now they'll say, you. What you said about the guy who liked the Patty's pies.
I mean, shoot, man. You know how he get down. They got boo-boo in the front and the back.
Hush.
He got boo-boo pies.
I don't want to hear about this.
But nah, man. I mean, see, I don't give a fuck. Do what you do.
Yeah.
You know, just don't keep me from trying to get to the stove with your parade and shit. I'm stuck in traffic.
This is
gone
so left.
Yeah, we went all the way left.
Come back. Look, come back. Come back to the right.
Let's come back, man. Thanksgiving is coming up. We got the pie shit was a little off the hinges. My mom makes lemon icebox pies. That she taught me the recipe. And
that one of which I have still not received.
Okay, I'm going to get you one.
Okay.
I went to the store today and got
the ingredients.
Yeah.
See, me and my sister, we have a. That's another reason I wasn't down with Patty's pies. Me and my sister for years have had an ongoing feud about who makes the best candy jams.
Mm. Now, see, here's what's crazy.
Tell both of them to make them. Everybody get. You know, you can never have too many candy.
Oh yeah,
yams.
We both make them now.
Yeah.
Is there a difference between yams and sweet potatoes?
Yes. They are different. Mm-hmm. Vegetables.
People don't know that, so that was a statement.
There is a yam and there is a sweet potato.
People didn't know that. Yeah, I love yams, but I don't like sweet potatoes. I can't.
Really?
I can't.
Is it the strings?
It's the aftertaste.
Yeah. Sweet potatoes too stringy.
Yeah, but I like sweet potatoes.
Like people eat sweet potato fries. I don't eat sweet.
Yeah,
potato.
I don't like sweet potato.
I don't like
fries.
That kind of.
Yeah.
The sweet potato needs some cinnamon and stuff.
I don't need that new shit. That sweet potato fries.
I like sweet potato.
What nothing wrong with regular French fries.
I eat a sweet potato and I've put some marshmallows in there.
Shout out to France.
And some caramel sauce. Cause it's a sweet. I mean, it's sweet. So
yeah,
I could eat
like,
a yam.
I don't
yam.
Like when people try to make sweet things savory. It's not savory. Mm. You just
yeah. Shout out to Paris and everybody in France for French fries. I'm glad they ain't hit the
You know they don't really call them French fries over there.
What they call them? Papas fritas.
No, just fried
they
potatoes.
Pommes frites.
That's it.
Not papas fritas.
That's the Spanish version.
No, that's not Spanish either.
That is Spanish.
They're pommes frites.
I mean.
But,
look,
yeah.
I want to ask you about this, right? Mm-hmm. So, Thanksgiving, it's when you out here with it, that means you got your main chick house that you going over and eating at. Then you got your side chick house that you gotta make feel important. I'm glad I'm out the game, man.
Side chicks can't cook.
Finally. I'm so proud of B, y'all.
Side chicks can't cook anyway.
I like
man.
To have done the run of Jericho.
What's the run of Jericho?
Well, you know, you run through the church and shout and jump over the pews and stuff. You gotta run like Jericho. But anyway, I'm very proud of B.
Well, you know, God has brought me such a mighty long way.
You are my finest project.
But you still my project. I had you hooked up with a football player.
No, you didn't.
NFL player.
No, you didn't.
And you dropped the ball. I saw this nigga in the mall this weekend.
Matter of fact, anybody out there who zoom in on Bridget, anybody out there who's interested, we will forward your emails and inquiries to Bridget.
Nope, yeah, thank you.
I shut down my Tinder.
Yeah, let's have a.
Oh, you mean it now?
I'm dead serious, man.
Shut the Tinder down.
Let's.
Okay.
I'm proud of you. Boy, I got a tear coming out of my eye. Jesus.
So look, but on the struggle side of the game, Lil Wayne's wife, well, Lil Wayne's baby mama was in the news because her husband now.
Was her ex-husband?
Huh? It's her ex-husband?
Well, okay, no. they were on
on that show, right? Exit Hollywood Exit. Some of
no, it was no, it was a show about how to split up their assets when they get a divorce.
Right. Okay.
So she was talking about how she gave him basically a week out of a year where he could go do what he wanted to do.
8 times a year actually to cheat a pass.
Mm-hmm.
You
okay, and people were making it seem like she's currently doing this. But this is what she was doing it while she was married. Yeah.
So, one of the comments,
she was doing it with Lil Wayne or her ex.
No, Memphis.
No. The guy name is Memphis.
Oh, which, Memphis.
Yeah.
I missed the T in the
long T Z sound.
They should have never taught you niggas how to read.
And
how to read.
And look.
Apparently, they didn't.
He get 8 passes a year to cheat, and he said he can't cheat without his pass. Ain't that some shit? That's some real nigga shit.
That ain't cheating though.
No, he said, because I watched the episode, they so seem, I can get an understanding of Will what Smith was going and, on. Because I Jada really was baffled. But okay, so she doesn't get a pass, but he gets a pass, and that's something that she allowed. She was very, very calm and very honest about that decision that she had made.
Right. Well, I mean, I guess what works for you is what works for you. But the other thing is, like, why, like, in the age of you porn and all of that, like, what you need that for?
Because you a hoe. That's what it comes down to. You just a hoe.
So, look, one of the people, they commented and they said, this is not what marriage is about. They are not in a biblical marriage. So I was like, what?
Yeah, you know they're going to bring up the Bible, man.
Actually, in the Bible.
Yeah, they have.
They are in a biblical marriage.
Yeah. Because the father of almost all Christianity, Judaism, and Islam had side chicks. Abraham had the whole Middle East conflict is about a side chick.
So how do black folks go to church
and don't know about the Bible?
Don't know about the Bible.
Well, because they're too busy listening to what they want to hear and not actually studying the word for themselves.
Like, I know somebody that's real close to me, actually as a family member, that whenever they don't want to do something, they say
it's ungodly.
No, they say, let's pray about it.
Or the people who fail at something and say, well, God must not have meant for that to happen, or...
I mean, I want to share a story, but...
Well, I don't like when people try to... Okay, so it's this one lady who would do prayers, and I'm not going to say where, because this would give up who she is. But anyway, she would do these prayers, and she would say, and we know that we got to stop saying that God is allowing these storms to happen and things like that, because he doesn't make storms. And I'm like, wait a minute. God is she talking about, though?
But think about it. That's actually true.
But he does create storms.
No, but when we talk about who bringing the storm, we talk about the devil.
No. I'm not talking about figurative storms. I'm talking about tornadoes. Like, this was during the tornadoes.
Oh, I'm tripping.
Tornadoes, hurricanes.
My bad. Okay.
Real storms.
Mm-hmm.
She said.
So
that.
Who is making these storms? That's what I'm trying to make.
Well, they say the
I
days.
Don't know who she was going to give credit to.
You know who actually doing it.
But it wasn't who was doing it.
The white man. It's this thing called a harp weapon. And the harp
just
weapon.
The devil, y'all.
I don't
want
to hear it. You sound just as ignorant as she is. She's doing the loud.
Y'all know it's the devil.
But yeah. But people always do stuff like that. Like, people make up things and say it's biblical. Like, cleanliness is next to godliness. That ain't in the Bible. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's true.
People make up all kinds of stuff and they'll be
I like that that's made up, because
because you should be clean.
Yeah, you should be clean.
That does make people want to be clean.
I've seen some unkempt bitches out here. This chick had hair on her nipple and it had dandruff on it.
I don't
want to
hear nothing about
that. But
you just made me touch my own shit.
Yeah, whenever somebody says, starts out a sentence with me, the Bible say, I just tune them out.
Yeah, anyway. You got to stop listening after people say, and the Bible says, especially when they say it with that voice, and the Bible says.
Right, because the Bible is like, it's big. It's 66 books. Like, well, nigga. I gave my, like, if I ever want to throw somebody off, I'll like add a verse. Like I said,
and see what they say.
And see what they say.
Because they're not going to catch it.
I said, Acts 29:4 says. He's like, hey, man. Like, if you real about your game,
right. Mm-hmm.
It's 28 chapters.
Mm-hmm.
But if I thought that 29. But look, so this is what I want to ask. As far as, like, dating, and especially here in Birmingham. Birmingham's been taken over by the church industrial complex.
It's hard.
There are a lot of beautiful, absolutely gorgeous black women in church that are single. But I believe the church industrial complex has made them undateable.
Yeah.
Now, when you say undateable, I need some examples of what makes a woman undateable.
Okay. I'm talking that... they have they are shallow and they cannot effectively elocute an opinion without it being elocute.
You were just making up words over there. Elocute.
Look it up.
Okay.
Elocute an opinion without quoting an erroneous Bible verse.
Even if it's a good Bible verse.
You remind me of a lot of black intellectuals who, when they learn three vocabulary words, they use those words.
Nah, that's Stephen A. Smith.
Every chance they get.
Stephen A. Smith say the same three big words over and over again.
You do too. Erroneous, nefarious.
Nefarious. That's my
okay.
That's one of my
Don't deflect.
That's yours too. Don't and deflect. What else?
Don't deflect from the question.
Oh, okay. Topic right now. It's another one that you use, and I'd be like,
don't vex me right now.
So, but I agree with be stuck in that. Like, it ain't Jesus or God. It's the church that has turned into their boyfriends.
Right.
Well, wait a minute now. Hold up.
So the pastor, and then he know what time it is because he got them up there with the spiritual moist panties.
Oh. Don't do that. We're going to change the whole subject.
Okay, all right. Don't let
me. We're not going to do this.
Okay.
No.
But I'm saying
this
that the church.
This is like the lady with the cock eyes. I'm not participating in this conversation.
The church industrial complex has largely made most women undateable.
I disagree.
Can they bring a balance? Can they effectively elocute a balance of conversation between Bible verses? And, like, what's going on in the world at large? Can you talk to me about Syria? Can you talk to me about...
I want to give a good example, man. Something a woman told me.
I think someone who is shallow is going to be shallow, whether they are in a church, whether they are in the world. I think that a shallow person is shallow regardless of where you find her.
Okay, so. I'll give you an example. A woman told me, right? She told me she can't date a man. And she was one of those people who are, like, $29,000 a year, and she was trying to, you know, kind of get her finances together, but, you know, she might need to borrow some money every now and then, and said she couldn't date a man who don't tithe.
Now she's
brainwashed
Christian.
Shit. Hmm?
Yeah. She's a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
If you really look into the Bible.
Well, no. We're not going to even go into, like, because we all, like, we kind of know, like, what the Bible kind of says about tithing and
right.
Like,
you
really
don't have to
tithe, right?
Right.
But
Jesus died.
But
so
what I'm saying is, that is indicative of, like, they will believe some bullshit. It doesn't even matter to me, like, if it's right according to the Bible or not, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's just that they will allow some bullshit from the Bible to determine their path in life.
But like I said before, someone who is shallow is going to be shallow whether they are a Christian, whether they are a Muslim, whether they are Jewish, whether they are agnostic. Any religion, that there are shallow people in every religion.
Right, I agree with
you. So if you are focusing on the shallow people and not on the people who actually have substance, because I'm a Christian and I'm pretty reasonable when it comes to who I date. Now, Brandon will say... Or be stuck, excuse me, will say that I make some porous decisions.
That's my word.
Yeah, porous is the other word. He'll say I make porous decisions. But they actually make a lot of sense. People are just located in different parts of the country. But that is a benefit to me because I don't like to be bothered.
Yeah.
All right, now moving forward.
I've been there.
Now, Bridget also has...
Okay, so we right there.
Dr. Burpo has area codes.
I do not have area codes.
Secret stashes that she has, that she pulls out.
These are lies.
And effectively elocutes.
These are lies.
So are there things in watching. The, like, so do you apply biblical tenets to your dating? Like, could you date a dude of another religion?
Yes, I could, actually.
So you don't mind not being equally yoked? Because niggas say yoke.
I really hate yoke. When people say yoke.
Yoked. With the L in it.
Right. I could not date an atheist, but I could date someone of a different religion. Yes.
What about
an agnostic?
What do agnostics believe?
Agnostics simply admit that they don't know. Like,
okay. But what do they believe? What do they believe in? Nothing, right?
No, it's not. I consider myself kind of an agnostic, and it's not like I don't believe in anything.
So what do agnostics believe in? Do they believe in a God?
Probably how you define it, no.
Well, then that's what, no.
What about Hotep?
No, okay. No,
absolutely nobody Hotep ever in life.
What's wrong with Hotep?
Oh, my God. What's right with a Hotep?
Have you ever met someone that's Hotep?
I have met several Hotep. I'm sitting next to someone
who is that motherfucker turned Hotep. Be stuck turn Hotep. And I was trying to pull him back out of it because I felt like I contributed to him going down that path. And he was like, but see, the Hoteps come out. Like, a person who's, first of all, like, I feel like once you become serious about consciousness, you got to be a Hotep is a step towards consciousness.
Oh, okay.
And if you're intelligent.
Hotep.
I'm a whole step. Ass nigga.
No. Okay.
That's whole. Like, I'm calling her a hoe and telling her to step.
Yeah.
That's that command and control.
That's not.
That's that call and response.
No. But, yeah.
You said you know somebody then. So.
I know several Hotep people.
That tried to date, like, a friend of yours or something?
No.
Oh, okay.
No.
Them Hotep niggas be wanting you to wear head wraps, though.
So, yeah, they do want you to wear your hair wrapped up and then be making all kind of comments about as a woman should behave. Meanwhile, they running a brothel in their apartment.
So what?
And all the Hotep niggas I know
are hoes.
No, they need to get back to the they don't use the same deodorant that.
Any deodorant
that the masses use.
That's what they say about Idris Elba. That nigga don't wear deodorant. And then, like, all the
hoes. He is English.
But I'm saying, like, he Hotep too, though.
No, he is not Hotep. You are not gonna do that to Idris Elba.
That's what old girl.
Idris
said.
Elba he has never been Hotep.
What's your Sarah name that dated? K Michelle.
But Idris said he ain't date her. He was knocking her down. You just say he ain't dated her.
Touche.
You gotta check your sources.
Well, look, man. One other point I was gonna make before we get out of here, right? So, the dating pool is getting smaller and smaller, right? And there's gonna be a lot of women left behind.
I'm one of those that you told me I'm gonna be left behind.
What?
I'm telling you, dude, for 2016, the Stay Woke Show, send in your solicitations. We can find.
I don't need solicitations.
No, I'm telling you.
No,
like,
she really don't. She got.
She just waiting through the fan mail.
She got sleeper sales. Mm-hmm. That's waiting to say, hey, baby, let's take this Ferris wheel.
So let me ask you this: do you get unsolicited dick pics?
Not anymore.
I'm just finding out about this. I find it fascinating that women get unsolicited dick pics.
Why is that?
But I have given some very hilarious responses to them. I'm pretty sure that I have been screenshot. Well, maybe not, because they wouldn't want nobody to know that I said those things. But I say, ew. Or, you know.
Women don't like.
We don't like that.
So why do men do that?
I don't know. Creeps. happens. Why do y'all do that?
I've never done it.
Mike, have you done it?
I don't know what the unsolicited. I'm just learning about this phenomenon.
Now,
I thought it was.
I have received news from women.
Were they unsolicited?
You solicited them. One of them was. Most of them is by request.
Right, by request.
So you always gotta do the request game. Mm-hmm. Would there be some sort of relationship adoption program?
No.
That will save women. No. That, I mean,
the real nigga robot 2.0, I'm telling you.
The real nigga robot. Would you?
No.
Do you see black women buying robots to be in?
No. No.
So what, I mean, we are very prideful people. We are very.
Have you heard? Okay, go ahead.
You know, what does prideful have to do with anything? No.
Well, because, you know, you don't want to. I mean, there's only so many times your grandma gonna bring you in at Thanksgiving during the holidays and say, "Where's your man?"
My grandparents have passed.
Not you. Your family don't try to hook you up. Like, I know so and so, he got a good job at the Walmart.
Because I think a lot of my family members know that I don't need help finding anybody. I am probably the problem.
Yeah, my family never tried to hook me up ever.
It's not meeting people.
Did y'all see the article that got everybody mad this weekend? Maybe mm-hmm. you're single because you're whack.
Oh no, I like that. I like that article because I'm probably very whack.
And then that goes to it made
a lot of sense.
But that was the point I was making about, you know, the church industrial complex here in Birmingham, is that. Chicks are really whack. That's what it is, man.
Yes, it is, right?
Anytime one neighborhood, West End has 56 churches.
Yeah.
In that one neighborhood, you think about how big Birmingham is.
Yeah.
That's a church industrial complex. So you have women in these facilities that are shallow, unkempt, unnurtured.
And giving them churches their money.
Just naming unwords.
Because they wait. All right. Undisciplined.
Mm-hmm.
Undiscerned.
Unexamined.
Just under. And, you know, they not adding anything to a relationship. And then you might see dudes going off to white women, Mexican women. You see my shirt. You know what I'm saying? I am.
But the sad thing about it, right, is that
I don't even think that has anything to do with the church. I think that has to do with the city of Birmingham.
No, in the city of Birmingham,
there is a level of comfort with mediocrity.
But that comes
and
from,
that goes. That's across the board, male, female. People in Birmingham are satisfied with being mediocre.
Let me tell you what it is, right?
Come on in.
It's not mediocrity. This whole
it is mediocrity.
You think about the politics and the construction of this city is based on history.
But I'm talking about what you're talking about, which is basic women, right?
But that shit ain't just from.
And I think that is a lot of people here in the city who are basic, and they are okay with being
driven by
basic.
The church.
But
what's
see,
that's what
I don't know
do.
If it's see. I don't know if it's like. Let me
it's
tell you.
It's not driven by the church. It's driven by the fact that everybody knows each other, and they all on the same level. From neighborhoods and schools.
No, what's the first thing they ask you?
I don't know everybody from. No, everybody don't. That ain't.
Yes,
the first. That's
do.
Old
you
people ask
Sixth
that.
Avenue.
What church you go to?
Same
old people
way.
Ask that.
No,
what 28-year-old will walk up to a 30-year-old and be like, "What church you go to?" Nobody
one
does.
One of them church holes.
Nobody.
Like, hey,
nobody
I'm
does
in a
that.
Relationship now.
Nobody does that.
Hey, people do it. You're wrong. You're wrong. I'm telling you. It's done. I'm telling you.
Nobody is.
But this is what. This is one.
I've never had anyone walk up to me and be like, "What church you go to?"
Not you. Telling you, you ain't no man. Women do
what?
That. You ain't no man. Women do that. I'm telling
women
you.
Do that.
I don't do that.
But
my
nah,
friends
I'm just
don't
saying,
walk up on people.
But what?
Like,
this is the only thing I want to say. All of that shit is based in a fairy tale, whether it's the Bible or like women, a bunch of basic women, like you call basic women, they have a list, and that list is generated by something, whether it's movies they watch. A man got to have a job and two cars and an education, and everybody has a list. And some basic women's list, because of the church industrial complex, is generated from the stuff they pastor told them and the stuff that they learned. Like, it's a bunch of women that go to these single groups at churches on Tuesday nights, and they go, we got a friend who does the conference, heads the conferences, and she's single.
Yeah.
She ain't got no man.
No, y'all gonna throw shade.
No, we ain't throwing shade. That's not shade.
Y'all ain't right. Talking about me, so I ain't worried about it.
I'm asking you, like, you got a master's degree, right? Mm-hmm. Would you take a class a class from somebody who had no experience and no knowledge in the subject?
No, I wouldn't.
But why not, though?
Because I would have more information. No, I would probably have a lot more.
You wouldn't even go to a school that allowed people to teach
that
weren't qualified in the subject.
Right.
Except churches do it.
Well, look, man, this is all I'm saying.
My church doesn't.
That church.
And you know it's the truth.
I mean,
my 80% of these churches down here, the pastors don't even have divinity degrees.
Yeah, rest in peace.
Rest in peace.
So look, y'all off camera. BJ, did you want to add something? BJ snuck in at the end.
Yeah, one of our past Stay Woke Show guests has been off camera in the studio the whole time, but he texting like a motherfucker.
Not at all.
He is tweeting.
Did you want to jump in real quick before we close out?
No.
All right, you straight. All right, so he off camera. Look, you got what you got coming up, Mike?
I'll be in Little Rock, Arkansas, December 12th. The 19th, I'm in Atlanta for the Rough Language Poetry Slam, michaelharriott.com. Check out The Rude and Very Smart Brothers if you want to see my writing.
All right. Now,
and Deadspin.
You got something real dope coming up. What you got coming up?
I'm getting inducted in Phi Kappa Phi.
Oh, you part of the Talented 10th. You part of the Illuminati. That's just the first step to the Illuminati.
I'm getting inducted in that December 3rd, December 12th.
I'll teach you the secret handshake.
Walking across the stage and receiving my master's. And then I'm headed on into my PhD.
All right. Well, look, December the 5th, Tuscaloosa.
Oh, wait. Excuse me. I'm sorry. December 21st is
when you
birthday.
Get your master's. I want to ask one question. When you get your master's and start on your PhD, are you going to start using the term Bridget, last name, comma,
M-E-D?
ABD?
Yeah.
I've already done it.
Okay.
M-E-D, yeah.
No, ABD. The people getting their PhD said they all but dissertation.
Oh, no.
You never heard? Like, you've never seen? I've seen people use that. That's like the most pretentious thing I've ever seen.
That is very pretentious.
That's some next level nigga shit right here.
Yeah, that's people don't have a master's already. Because you can just put, you already have letters.
M-E-D,
right?
They don't have no letters.
Yeah, they don't have any letters.
Well, look, man, it's my turn.
And go.
December the 5th, Tuscaloosa, I'm coming to you. First Friday.
He's funny as hell, actually, y'all. I'm telling y'all. He made me laugh every time I see him, and I see him a lot.
Yeah, so I'm going to be doing that with Steve Brown and Terry T. That should be on fleek.
Bringing the message of thoughts to your neighborhood.
That's it. And at the end of the week, I'll be pulling up at my auntie house with an empty stomach, about to let loose on that mac and cheese and all that good stuff. And look, man, y'all have a great Thanksgiving, thanks holiday. Thank y'all for tuning in. And stay woke.
Stay woke.
Stay woke.
Stay woke.
What we got to say ain't no joke.
It's no joke.
Peace.
We out.
That's when the music comes.